So the title of today's lesson is Like a Child, Be Childish. We're going to start at Matthew 18, and we're going to start at the first verse. At the same time came the disciples unto Jesus, saying, Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? And Jesus called a little child unto him, and set him in the midst of them, and said, Verily I say unto you, except ye be converted and become as little children, ye shall not enter into the kingdom of heaven. Whosoever therefore shall humble himself as this little child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoso shall receive one such little child in my name, receiveth me. So there are three things that I'm going to discuss today that we can apply that will help us to be like children in our walk with God. First, we have to be teachable. To be teachable means to be able to learn by being taught. You don't think you have everything figured out. Secondly, innocence. Innocence is described as being pure, naive, not guilty of crime or offense. Now, does that mean that if we have a bad record or we've sinned or made a mistake that we can't come to God? No, but we have to have the desire to allow God to purify us by following His commandments. And lastly, we have to be curious about the right thing. To be curious means to be eager to know or learn something. You have to hunger and thirst after the things of God. Be curious. And Matthew 5 and 8 says, Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Kids are pure, so we need to be like a child. Be childish. Next, we have Luke 12 and 7. But even the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore. Ye are of more value than many sparrows. Now, I'm pretty sure some of you remember that if you think about some of the things that you are afraid of now as an adult, when you were younger, you probably weren't afraid of those things. So in this scripture, Jesus is encouraging his disciples to be fearful of nothing. He cares about us, so he doesn't want us to have the spirit of fear. Now we're going to turn to James 1 and 5. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God that giveth to all men liberally and upbraideth not, and it shall be given him. So this ties in with being eager, because if you're eager and you're hungry for the things of God and you desire to be wise and to grow in understanding of his word, God will give you that revelation and understanding. I promise. I'm a living witness. I love you. And if you have any prayer requests, you can send them to me. Oops. I'm like a child.